Punjab was the best model has been launched in the world of the Green Revolution. What is the situation in Punjab now? I have traveled throughout Punjab many times. I have given my 21 workshops in the Punjab. What I am seeing there, those Punjabi farmers who were producing 30 quintal per acre wheat, now they are not growing more than 12 quintal. Why? Every village is committed by the cancer patients. Lot of cancer patients are existed in each village. There is a train from Bhatinda to Bikaner that is called cancer train. Why? I have the figures given by the government agencies, and those figures says that by means of the green revolution, chemical farming, per acre production of every crop is continuously reducing. That means, by means of the chemical farming, per acre production is continuously reducing. We have the double target, 200 to 50 crore metric ton of the food grain, double target. And we have limited 350 million acres of the land for cultivation. We can't increase the land because there is no any technology has been devised by the agricultural institute that land is manufactured in the factory. That means we have limitation. This is the reality. This is the reality that if we want double production, chemical farming is totally useless. Totally useless. If it is a reality that chemical farming, agriculture universities are totally useless to give the double production, what is the solution they have? There is no solution with the agriculture university. Why they are taking the salaries? Why they are getting the funds? And I am, what has happened? All the agricultural experts, agricultural scientists and professionals are supporting Green Revolution while they are continuing their jobs, and after retiring job, they are against the Green Revolution. Today also we have seen, after retirement, Jalpati Rao is speaking against the Green Revolution. Not before retirement. They have sold their lives to the system. What they can do? What they can do? They can speak only. They can't do anything for the society. So, Sathiyo, we have the solution. We have the solution. Zero budget natural farming movement is having the solution. Because we have proved. We have proved that only zero-budget natural farming is the solution by which we can increase the per-acre production. We have proved it scientifically. The paddy, basmati paddy, is the best, Dehradun basmati, the best variety of the paddy in the world, scented, aromatic variety. I have visited all the beds of the basmati in northern India, maybe Uttarakhand, maybe Jammu Kashmir, maybe Himachal Pradesh, maybe Punjab, Haryana, and the Tarai region of the Sikkim, Bhutan, and Nepal. I have seen. You may apply maximum quantity of the chemical fertilizer to basmati. You can't get more than 12 quintal per acre production per acre. By means of the chemical farming. You utilize maximum quantity of chemical fertilizer. You are totally unable to increase the production more than 12 quintal. But you go in this belt of the basmati, you will see Our farmers are practicing Jhoban natural farming in Dehradun Basmati, and they are getting more than 18 to 24 quintal per acre production. Mr. Vijayaramji is here. You go in his field, he is growing the basmati in Jhoban natural farming, and he said that the more than the figures of the agricultural universities, he is getting basmati production in Jhoban natural farming. Every farmer. We have proved that only solution is Jhoban natural farming to solve this food crisis problem. Only solution. This Bansi variety of the local wheat Bansi is the best local variety coming since lakhs of the year in India, in the central part of India. We have conserved this seed and we have distributed to the people, to the farmers who are practicing Jhoban natural farming. Best variety. You utilize maximum quantity of the chemical fertilizer, you will not getting more than 6 quintal per acre production in chemical farming of this local variety of the wheat Bansi. But in Jhoban natural farming, our farmers have taken 18 quintal per acre production in Jhoban natural farming of basmati local variety. We have proved maybe cereals, maybe millets, maybe pulses, maybe oilseed, maybe fruit, maybe orchard, maybe vegetable. In all sector of the food material, we have proved by means of the natural farming, we are taking more production than chemical and organic. Openly, you can go and visit our models. You will see the big difference, what difference in between the chemically grown, organically and naturally grown. Sathiyo, even we are going to convert all the forests in the orchard forests so that the food problem can be solved. And we have started this movement in South India to convert the forest land into the orchard land. Not only the wild trees will be there, but in between two wild trees, there will be our own food trees also, just like our pomegranate, drumstick, custard apple, chilies, turmeric, ginger, all the spices, even vegetables also, very successfully. Because we have only limited land, we can't manufacture the land in the factory, so we have to utilize this land for only food grain production. If it is the demand of the time, that we want double production, we have limited 35 crore acre land for cultivation, then it is the duty of the government of India, it is the duty of every farmer to utilize maximum area, maximum land for only cultivation practices, to grow the food material, only food material, so that we can compensate the deficit. But we are seeing that we are destroying the land under the development process, so-called development process. You see, urbanization, farmer a world famous economist, and he was a prime minister of India for 10 years. Dr. Manmohan Singh has said in the parliament 50% rural people will be shifted to the urban area. Now at Visakhapatnam there was a national conference in the Andhra Pradesh University. There was my speech there. One renowned economist, Radhakrishnanji, renowned economist in the world. His name is taken for the famous, that is, what is called? Nobel Prize. I heard his name lot of time, and he has given the speech on the dais in this workshop, in the seminar, and I was surprised. This fellow is a great economist in India, in entire world also. He has no solution has been given in his speech. Only he is analyzing the problems. And he has given the statement, 65% rural people will be shifted. Where? He has not given the clearance. Maybe on the Mars, maybe on the Moon. Maybe. Because we have sent a satellite on the Mars. When 50% of the rural people will be shifted to the urban area, they want their houses, they want another infrastructure, shops and all these things, markets, services, a big infrastructure we have to build up where the soil will be available. They will take the soil from the farmers by the laws or by the weapon. Whether the area will be increased or decreased, this 35 crore acre land will be cut down continuously for the development, so-called development. How we can compensate 50 crore acre, crore metric ton of the food grain production by reducing land? How? This is the question we have to ask agriculture experts, universities and governments also. This is the big challenge to the human being. Big challenge, not created by the nature, created by only human being. So-called development process. Now, globalization. Globalization means to increase the growth rate of the economy. And two, when we increase the growth rate of the economy means everybody, every human being has to purchase something and sell something at any time, at same time. The first commodities are manufactured in the big industries. Make in India, made in India, made in China, made in Brazil, made in Europe, made in America. And consumers are committed to purchase by giving the 6-pay commission, 7-pay commission in their pockets. By giving the big advertisement, and they are linked to the banking sector to take the loans easily. That means when anybody is purchasing one car, two cars, three cars, TV, they will build up the so many houses in Bangalore, in Hyderabad, in New Delhi, in New York, in Mars, in Sun, and Moon also. Because they are getting the big salaries by means of the 7-pay commission. Again, land will be cut down. And to manufacture all these commodities, consumerized commodities, raw material is coming from the nature. Again, nature is totally destroyed. The natural resources are continuously destroyed. And when these big infrastructure of the industries to manufacture all these commodities, consumerized commodities, luxurious commodities, the huge quantity of the smoke will be emitted in the atmosphere. These are the greenhouse gases which are responsible for global warming, climate change. And what are the hazardous impact of the global warming and climate change? Now we are seeing throughout the world. What is the meaning of the development? To destroy the natural resources is the development in which dictionary it is given. Ye arthashastra nahi hai, ye anarthashastra hai, anarthashastra. And if speedily, on the name of the development, we will destroy the natural resources, soil, water, environment, space, and human being, and including all living being. We will destroy it continuously. One time it will be finished. All the natural resources will be finished. How future generation will survive? This is the question we have to ask to the promoter of the development. How future generation will survive? This is the time now we have to think seriously about this aspect. For that purpose, you are participated in this workshop. To give the solution, to give the solution. So that our future generation can survive, our future generation. Nature can be survived, natural resources can be sustained. When in international seminar, I was also invited. The subject was sustainable agriculture and sustainable development. Once 65 countries were participated. And everybody was giving the lecture, big lectures about the development. What are the advantages of the development? What is the definition of the sustainable agriculture? What is the definition of the sustainable development? Real definition I would like to give you. That agriculture technology is the sustainable agriculture by which all the natural resources will be sustained. That is the sustainable agriculture. That development is sustainable development, by which all natural resources will be sustained for future generation. That is the real definition of the sustainable development. And you are giving the definition, sustainable development is the destruction. How everybody can accept it? That means it is the time now we think about the policies, we think about our duties, and we think about our lifestyle laws. Sathiyo, global warming and climate change is a big challenge to the human being. We have to discuss few minutes for that purpose because it is a main problem now. This global warming, climate change is discussed throughout world. In the media, in individual gossips and internal conferences between the decision makers of every country in India, in the world. Now in the Paris, there is a convention now. Entire 180 countries will be participating in that convention. The subject, global warming and climate change. What is the global warming? Let us discuss for a few minutes. When the sun rays are coming, sunlight is coming toward the earth. The solar energy is coming in the form of the photon particles. Again, with the sunlight, sun energy, solar energy, some radiations are also coming to the earth. And main radiation is ultraviolet rays. Ultraviolet rays, ati nil kiran. When these ultraviolet rays are coming, and our human body is exposed to the ultraviolet rays, there is a big change in our internal body. The genetic setup in the DNA is totally upsetted, and genetical formation is changed. The skin diseases are appeared. Even we lose our immunity, resistance power of the human body is reduced, infertility is increased, and we face so many problems. Just like at the age of the 16 year, any child become matured, that means any girl is matured, but now it has happened that in the 9th year also she becomes matured. It is totally unnatural things what happened because of the ultraviolet rays. When these ultraviolet rays are coming and the plant body is exposed to the ultraviolet rays, the crops are exposed, the resistance power is reduced, new generation of the viruses are coming to attack, new generation of the insecticides, insects also are coming to attack, and entire crop is damaged. The resistance power is continuously reducing of the crop. And now 14% productivity is decreased by means of the ultraviolet rays. That means there is a great hazardous impact of the incoming ultraviolet rays on the entire natural resources, including human beings. So God has created a beautiful system to restrict the incoming ultraviolet rays, and they have created one layer on the atmosphere that is called ozone layer. Ozone layer upon the atmosphere. That ozone gas layer absorbs the ultraviolet rays from the sunlight. Sunlight is filtered, and ultraviolet rays free sunlight is coming to the earth, and we are safe from the ultraviolet rays. That means this ozone gas layer upon the atmospheric sphere is the border security force to restore entire living being on the earth, including vegetation also. Afterward, it happened that this ozone layer is going to destroy. There are the big holes are created in the ozone layer. And afterward, it happened to destroy the ozone layer, there are some greenhouse gases are responsible. And then this issue is become in the gossip, in the very serious problem in the world. Then our United Nations organization has committed one global committee to find out the impact of the global warming climate change on the natural resources, what are the impact and what will be the future solution. They have constituted one international body. The name has given to the body IPCC, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. And Dr. Rajendra Pachauri was the chairperson of that IPCC committee. And every 3 months they are publishing one report And that report says that there is a hazardous impact of the global warming and climate change on the entire natural resources. I have not seen the hail storm in October, November. I have seen the hail storm all coming in India, but not before in southern path of the sun. Dakshinayan kal mein kabhi bhi himpat nahi hota tha. Now we are seeing that after 14th of the January, that means in the initial stage of the northern path of the sun, the hail storm was continued in the past. Now we are seeing in the October, November, there is a hail storm. Climate is totally changed. I am a cotton grower. Since my childhood, I am a farmer. I have not seen mealybug on the cotton. I have not seen at all.